I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey, whippersnappers. Brian here at A Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. On this channel, I listen and react to rap and hip-hop songs. It's a genre I know very little about, but I'm learning more with every reaction. I'm kind of in the middle of a deep dive on Tupac. Tupac has a lot of love on this channel. So I have a lot of requests for him, and that's what I'm here for. Today's request is for Me Against the World, off the album of the same name. Requested by Mohammed Shoka, That One Guy, and Tariq. So thanks, guys. Just like, what was it? So Many Tears. I'm assuming recorded in the same period of time between the sexual abuse charge and the trial. And of course, the quad shooting, but Pac had no idea at the time that that was going to happen. But I'm sure the trial was weighing heavily on him, and this is the period when he wrote this. And I can see why he wrote something with this title, because it must have seemed like, you know, everyone was against him. When I looked up this song, you know, to find a lyric video, one of them said featuring Dramacidal, and I had never heard that. You know, I've done some Pac videos for my East Coast West Coast rivalry, and you would have thought I would have heard of Dramacidal, but I guess it's they're from earlier on. It's Big Malcolm, Young Hollywood, Muta, and K-Dog. So I found out that when Pac got released from prison in late 95, those four guys, the Dramacidal guys, they were merged with the members of Thug Life, and then they got a new name, Outlaws. So when later when Pac was doing music with Outlaws, it's a mixture of these two groups, Thug Life and Dramacidal. After they merged, Big Malcolm became Edie, I mean, K-Dog became Castro, Young Hollywood became Gaddafi, and Muta became Napoleon. I'm familiar with the name Gaddafi because when I was doing the episode in my series when Pac dies, I remember that Gaddafi, who was in the car behind Shogun Pac, the night of when he was talking to the police, he said that he saw who the shooter was, and he said he didn't think it was Orlando Anderson. And then, you know, they let him go, you know, and he was going to come back and give them more details. But the Las Vegas police didn't have any help from, you know, death row trying to get a hold of Gaddafi. And then he ends up being accidentally shot in New Jersey. I suppose all of that just could have been coincidence, but, you know, here's someone who's saying he doesn't think it was Orlando Anderson, and then he ends up dead. It's just suspicious to me. Anyway, so this is Me Against the World from Me Against the World, released when Pac was in prison. I hate that story. You know, that this number one album came out, you know, his baby, this art that he had worked on and wanted to share it with his fans. It happens while he's in prison on this, you know, bum charge. Okay. Tupac. Me Against the World, from Me Against the World, released in 95.
in the city, the cops are stopping me. The project's full of bullets, the bodies is dropping. They ain't no stopping me. Constantly moving while making millions. Witnessing killings, leaving dead bodies in the abandoned buildings. Carries the children because they're illing. Addicted to killing and the appeal from the cap villain. Without feeling, but will they last or be blasted? Or that it's past it? Maybe you're listening in this casket. The aftermath, more bodies being buried. I'm losing my homies in a hurry. They're relocating to the cemetery. Got me worried. Stressing my business blurry. The question is, will I live? No one in the world loves me. I'm headed for danger. Don't trust strangers. Put one in the chamber whenever I'm feeling this anger. Don't want to make excuses, because this is how it is. What's the use unless we're shooting? No one notices the youth. It's just me against the world, baby.
Me against the world.
It's me against the world.
Ooh.
It's just me against the world.
Me against the world.
Because it's just me against the world.
Of my birth on this earth is what I'm dreaming. Seeing daddy seeming full of crooked demons. Daddy be crazy and screaming. I guess them nightmares as a child had me scared, but left me prepared for a while. Share another rap for a crooked outlaw, a veteran, a villain, a young thug.
Every day is more depth, and plus I'm no less. I'm CMO reasons for me to proceed with thieves. Scheme on a scheme and lead every screaming. Cause ain't no punch to stack up. My nuts is backed up. I'm about to act up. Go to the Mac up. Now watch me clack up. Try make a fact up. But yo, it ain't working. And evil's lurking. I can see him smirking.
Sorry, I have to pause it. I do that when I don't understand something, even when I see it written. He's risking 25 to L. Oh, prison sentence, 25 to life. Okay. Sorry.
The question I wonder is after death, after my last breath, when will I finally get to rest through this suppression? They punish the people that's asking questions and those that possess. Still from the ones without possessions, a message I stress. To make it stop, study your lessons, don't settle for less. Even the genius asks questions, be grateful for blessings. Don't ever change, keep your essence. The power is in the people, in politics we address. Always do your best, don't let the pressure make you panic. And when you get stranded and things don't go the way you planned it, dreaming of riches, in a position of making a difference. Politicians are hypocrites, they don't want to listen. If I'm insane, the fame made a proper change. It wasn't nothing like the game, it's just me against the world.
There's a bright day after that. So no matter how hard it gets, stick your chest out, keep your head up, and handle it.
That is totally not what I was expecting. I was expecting angry and frustrated, but it was you know, such a great slow jam. That's what you call it, right? It's one of my more favorite Pac songs. but the dichotomy of, you know, the truths that he's speaking, you know, the disturbing truths that he's speaking, and the, you know, the chill laid back style of his delivery, really makes it a special song, I think. It, you know, I recently did Blasphemy from 7 Day Theory, and it has some kind of the same feel for me as this, when he's talking about, you know, the hypocrites that are in power. And I thought a lot about Blasphemy after I listened to it, you know, about how, you know, the us regular people are not the sinners. The sinners are the people who are supposed to be taking care of us and not doing that, not you know, keeping up their oath to take care of us, you know, public servants, politicians, you know, that they don't take care of us, you know, that, you know, they want to cut aid to people and, you know, while they have a great job with great benefits, they're telling people, you know, just go get a job, while they basically do nothing other than, you know, take checks from, you know, a big business. And the clergy, you know, they're supposed to be watching out for us, but, you know, all they're doing is taking our money. And the police, you know, protect and serve, and what are they doing? They're, you know, killing mostly, you know, men of color. I don't think that's protecting and serving. So anyway, this, it seems to be a running theme, because this song was much earlier, but when he was talking about it, certainly made me think of Blasphemy, maybe because it was so fresh in my mind. Anyway, he had a lot to say in this, and, you know, like I said, the chill vibe makes you think that what he's saying is maybe not as important as it should be. Like, if he had delivered it more emphatically, people maybe would have listened. Because it's such a, you know, a chill song, people are probably just bopping to it and not realizing that, you know, he's saying, you know, there's a lot of shit going down in the world, and do your best not to have it pointed at you. But then the last little spoken part that he did, where it's just, you know, like, keep your head up, hang in there. I thought it was great. If you like hanging out with me and you like this kind of content, subscribe and like, and I'll see you on the next episode. Thanks, you guys, for recommending that. Bye.